Feminist Creativist presents a word for every generation that knows no fashion.
Greetings. I hope and trust I find you well, my dear friends. We have one more mountain experience as we begin our working week. I invite you to the book of Judges. We are at chapter 5, and we want to read from verses 1 up to verse number 5. The Bible reads as follows. On that day, Deborah and Barak, son of Abinoam, sang, "When the leaders lead in Israel, when the people volunteer, praise the Lord. Listen, kings, pay attention, princes. I will sing to the Lord. I will sing praise to the Lord God of Israel. Lord, when you came from Seir, when you marched from the fields of Edom, the earth trembled, the heavens poured rain, and the clouds poured water. The mountains melted before the Lord, even Sinai before the Lord, the God of Israel." May the good Lord bless the reading of His word as we call upon the God of Israel in prayer. Let us pray, my friends. Kind and gracious Father, in the heavens above, thank you, dear Lord, for the privilege of calling upon your name. Early in the morning, allow us to sing praise unto your name and say, "How excellent is thy name and all thy works among men." Be with us as we go into our professional spaces, but before we do so, may we hear from the word of the Lord. In Jesus' name we pray and ask, amen. My good friends, allow me to raise, as usual, 5 points as we take off. Notice that we meet at this point Deborah. Deborah is a prophetess. Deborah is the judge of Israel. She is with the son of Abinoam, and his name is Barak. Barak is a child of the house of Naphtali. He is their leader. Now on this day, Deborah calls upon the son of Naphtali, Barak, and she says, "It is time that we go and take on Jabin from the Canaanite kingdom." He was the king, and Jabin had brought the children of Israel under some form of bondage. He was said to have 900 iron chariots. Now, as Deborah says, "The Lord has given Jabin into your hand. Go out, mobilize in the house of Naphtali and the house of Zebulun, and go and attack." But Barak is not so confident to do so. And Deborah at this point tells him, that if you do not go and do it, the Lord is going to give the life of Sisera into the hands of a woman, and she will gain the glory. But Barak insists on going with Deborah. They go out, Sisera mobilizes. As he comes out to face and fight Barak, the troops of Sisera are thrashed. And as they ran off, the Bible says, this particular man, Sisera, goes into the house of Jael, where he seeks refuge. The lady there covers him up, gives him some cold milk. As he sleeps, she takes the tent peg and drives it through his temple, right into the soil. As Barak comes over, he finds the man already dead. And they all celebrate, and they continue to victor and vanquish over the city of the Canaanites, and Jabin is eventually overcome. It is at this point that we find Deborah now in a duet with Barak. They are celebrating. What are they celebrating? The dethroning of Jabin. And as I am talking to you, as you go into the workspace, what am I saying? Take time to celebrate the victories that come your way. Take time to give glory, honor, and praise to the Lord on high, for He victors over you, and He is the conqueror. He is the one who has not lost any battle, and He will see you through. Take time to sing songs. You have come this far. Celebrate, celebrate, celebrate. We're already 9 months into the year. Is that not cause to celebrate? We are already a couple of weeks right into September. Isn't that a cause to celebrate? Spring has come along. Is that not cause to celebrate? Celebrate the goodness that the Lord has brought upon us. And at point number two, notice that as she celebrates, she says at verse number two, "When the leaders lead in Israel." This is something that she celebrates, for there is a drought of true leaders. We need to celebrate when we get such leaders. We need to take time to say, "Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for the leaders that you have given us, for they are rare and far between nowadays. Many a leader that we have seeks to gratify self before they do anything for the followers. Take time to celebrate, and I want to challenge you, celebrate your MD, celebrate your CEO, celebrate your manager, celebrate your superior, celebrate all those who take a lead role in your life. And above all, celebrate your parents. Celebrate whosoever leads out in your life. Point number three. She goes on to say, at verse number two, I love this. When the people volunteer, praise the Lord. We have so many who want to be leaders nowadays, but very few are willing to be volunteers. Very few are willing to follow. Very few are willing to be led and advised. When you get people who are willing to give of their time, give of their resources so that the mission can be achieved, praise the Lord. Point number two, celebrate the leaders. Point number three, celebrate when you are a leader having a follower. Celebrate if you are a follower, the attitude of being led. This is a rare thing nowadays. Everyone wants to do things their way. Everyone wants to be the leader. As you go into the workspace and you find yourself in a subordinate role, praise be to the Lord. This is not so easy. Many of them who claim to even follow are not following at all. They are in passive resistance. Point number four. I love this point. At verse number three, listen, kings. Pay attention, princes. Listen, kings. Pay attention, princes. Why does Deborah seek to single out the nobility, the royalty? With power comes the propensity not to listen very well. We get so accustomed to being the ones who give the instructions, and we do not take time to listen to instructions. We get so accustomed to being praised, and we do not have time to praise the Lord God Almighty. With power. Somebody said, was it Shakespeare? Absolute power corrupts absolutely. With power comes the deafening of our ears. With power comes a busy schedule that we have no time for God. Take time as kings when you have ascended to the positions of glory. Take time to praise the Lord. Take time to sing of the Lord, and take time to pay attention to what he says. And this brings us to point number five as we climax. I want to notice and take note of this song. There is a literary device that Deborah uses here. She uses a creative style, poetic license. She begins to speak about things that never happened, but she still draws our attention to how nature responds to the love of God, how nature praises God. Look again at verse number four. It says, Lord, when you came out from Sire, when you marched from the fields of Edom. This is Sire. This is where God said, when you get to Sire, make sure you are going to pay for the food that you're going to eat, because this land I've given it to the Edomites, your cousins. So she says, when you marched out of Sire, out of that place, what happened? The earth trembled. It might have not literally trembled, but this is poetic license to show that indeed there is a response from nature to God. Not only did it tremble, the heavens poured rain. That's how nature, responds to God. And she says, the clouds poured water. And at verse number five, the mountains melted before the Lord. How soon can our hearts melt before the Lord? Will they ever melt? Obstacles are removed. Even the Mount Sinai, which was up and above, she says, even Sinai before the Lord God of Israel melted and disappeared. God is given room and God is praised. May the God Almighty be praised by you and I, for he is worthy of all the praise. He has overcome in all that has been troubling us. He has given us positions of leadership and positions of followership. As we lead, as we follow during this week, let us take time when we have assumed our responsibilities to listen to the God Almighty. And above all, to respond to his call and invitation. Let us meet tomorrow evening at 1800 hours Southern African time for the Togetherness Week as we continue with the Church of Breath of Life in Britain. God bless you.